Now I'm doing a pure abstraction, just with paper, loosely using it. Not letting it govern me, just getting a broad idea. I use the same beginning of an organic shape I did with the water. Same thing I used with the black and white study. So I continued with that idea because that anchor helped me to manipulate the rest of the surface. In other words, I do not like to work. Work is for booty. I'm making the white part of the project. And any luck at all, it'll actually work. You never know. What's happening?
Yeah, wow.
You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It begins to stimulate an idea from this, not of it. And that's the trail you take into abstraction. That's only one trail. The other trail is Modriano, which is also quite complicated and remarkably interesting. If you don't like, if you like headaches, stay away. Because I had at least a headache every time Vid made me go look at them. Because I didn't know what the hell he was doing. It took me 5 years to understand, oh yeah, it's a language of movement. I was making all these big issues. Any of them were black somewhere. Now the best glue actually used with this is a bookbinder's glue called jade glue. Bookbinders use it because it's acid-free, and they use it to take old books and bind them back together. It's a remarkable glue. And if you find a place where the craft area used to be in the 40s, I don't know where it is now.
In Brooklyn.
Brooklyn, naturally. Some god-awful place you can't get to. So, but if you go there, they usually have the glue. I used to go to New York Central, but the developers destroyed that. So now I gotta hope and pray. Jade glue?
Yes.
Well, that's good. Of course, I don't use it, but that's okay.
Oh, all right.
I'll let you do it, and then I'll pay you.
Okay. Anytime.
I got a real hate relationship going with Amazon.
Who doesn't?
They keep telling me I'm a member. I said, a member of what?
A member of destroying Brooklyn Waters.
Yes. Destroying Queens. Okay, now I'm getting silly, but it's starting to work somehow. now this is called dressing the shape. Each one dresses it in a different way. It's a way of adding an energy to a form without doing too much work. Pretty simple. Let me run this over the top again, just a little bit. When you take a white and you put it on a white, and I go around in class sometimes trying to get you guys to do that, you're really just building the weight of the volume so it moves. If you see it's too far behind, you just add paint to it. You don't have to make it a color or a form. You can just simply add weight to it and it will change its position. See what I mean? Difference, moves it up, and then you're doing again, you're forcing the surface to become part of the idea. And that's the name of the game, so to speak. Just to push that under there. Take a little sliver. Get bring my optic.
Would you ever put a full value or white or black on top of what you did the
oh,
first part?
Yeah. Sure, I've done it.
Yeah,
make it jump. Absolutely. Overlapping, underlapping, that kind of thing. And next thing you know, I actually got something. Any luck at all? Okay. So there's your basic idea. So you see how easy all this stuff is. I used the old paper to do it, so I got a collage on both sides. I usually sell watercolors that way because I know it's a lot of people. Hmm.